the Millionaire hot seat tonight. Hot seat, hot site, you name it, it's hot. And we've got a brand new show, hour-long show, bringing back some of the great millionaire favourites, Fastest Finger First and The Lifelines, giving everybody the biggest and best chance of winning $1 million. How about that, everybody? Cannot wait. Our six contestants will play two rounds of Fastest Finger First. Each contestant has a touch screen. I'll show them the question. Four alternative answers are there. They'll have 10 seconds to look for the answer and lock it in. At the end of 15 questions, the contestant who's locked in the most correct answers but in the fastest time wins $1,000 cash. Well done. That's it. And that's where it just starts, because that $1,000 then can be traded in and buy a lifeline later on in the show. Those lifelines are 50-50, ask a friend, or the switch, which gets rid of the question altogether, in the main game when we're playing for the big money of $1 million tonight. Let's meet our contestants playing for that $1 million tonight. And in seat number one, we have Trish Hong, who ate pizza with British actor Warren Mitchell from Till Death Us Do Part. After a big night, Akiva Kennard couldn't get in the door, so he tried to crawl through the cat flap. Rachel Mountford met her now husband in kindergarten, but only reconnected last year on Facebook. Kate Ward always has a few hobbies on the go, but never finishes any of them, Kate. Steve Graham snorkeled in a city fountain that he'd filled with dishwashing liquid. And David Rao looked like he'd been shot after eating an ice cream sundae with raspberry sauce. There you go. All right, guys. Round one is ready to go. It's time to play Fastest Finger First. Good luck, everybody. Heads down. Let's go for it. Question one. According to a common Australian expression, a strong, healthy person is said to be as fit as a what bull? A. Murray. B. Murrumbidgee. C. Mallee. D. Chicago. Murray Bull, Murrumbidgee Bull, Mallee Bull, Chicago Bull. People are frustrated already. We're only at question one. Settle down, guys. The answer is a Mallee Bull. The green light tells us who got it right. Five people got it. And position number three, Rachel, was the fastest. Well played. Question two. Founded in Ohio in 1969, which of these is one of the world's largest hamburger chains? A. Steve's, B. Wendy's, C. Michael's, D. Linda's. 1969 in Ohio. One of the world's largest hamburger chains is B. Wendy's. Again, we're looking for a green light for those who got it right. Green lights everywhere bar next door to me. And position four, Kate is the fastest this time. Well done, Kate. Good job. Question three. An HC license required to drive an articulated truck with three or more axles stands for heavy what? A. Carriage. B. Cartage. C. Connection. D. Combination. Carriage, cartage, connection, combination, heavy what? HC license. Answer is combination. Did anyone get this one right? No, 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 no. No one got it right. Everybody got it wrong. Okay, question four. This is a visual question, so have a look at the screens. Have a good look there. Now the question. Located in Canberra, what is this building? A, the Australian War Memorial. B, National Gallery. C, the Old Parliament House. D, National Film and Sound Archive. Located in Canberra, what is that building? It is the Australian War Memorial. Wonderful place to go and visit as well. Who got it right? Green lights, we have three of them, and Kate in seat four was the fastest again. Well played, Kate. Question five. Eric Clapton was a member of a short-lived rock trio of the late 1960s called what? A. Cream. B. Hot Chocolate. C. Sherbet. D. The Supremes. Eric Clapton. Slow Hand. 1960s. And the group was called A. Cream. We're looking for green lights. Everyone got Cream. And seat five, Steve, was the fastest. Good on you, Stevie. 0.08. No Slow Hand for you, pal. You had the fastest finger there by a mile. Question six. What was Australia's final gold medal tally at the 2016 Olympic Games in Rio de Janeiro? A6, B8, C10, D12. 2016 Olympic Games in Rio, final gold medal tally for the Australian team. It was B8. Anyone get this one right? Oop. Bit like the Australian team. Not up to scratch there, guys. Anyway, missed out. Next question. Question 7. Which of these words means the opposite of quandary? A, predicament. B, imbroglio. D, dilemma. D, solution. Predicament, imbroglio, dilemma, solution. What is the opposite of a quandary? The answer is D, the solution. The others are all problems. Everybody got that one right. Position 2, Akiva got the money this time. Well played. Let's have a look at the leaderboard now. And Trish at the moment is in front on percentage, if you like, from Kate. Come on, Trish. She hasn't won any of the fastest fingers yet, Trish, but she has been answering in a pretty measured tone there and has got them all right there. So 5 questions right. Kate has got 5. And then is Kate. Hello, Kate. Let's go back to the leaderboard and see that 4 and 4 for Steve and Akiva. David's got 4 as well, and Rachel on 3. So everyone still in the hunt. And Akiva's been answering pretty quickly. So if you can get one extra point up there, he'll be in top position. Everybody has a big chance to win $1,000 and even better, to get a lifeline playing for $1 million in the hot seat. To the Millionaire Hot Seat. We're just about halfway through Fastest Finger First. At the end of 15 questions, the contestant who has locked in the most correct answers in the fastest time wins the grand. That's what it's all about. And, of course, gets the chance to be able to swap that money for use of one of the lifelines. All right, let's get back to the questions now. We are looking at the leaderboard before we get to them. Trish is just hanging in there beautifully at the moment, leading by a percentage, if you like, or time on Kate on 5, then 4-4-4 down to David. Rachel's on 3. Everybody a big chance. 2 separating first from last at the moment. This is question 8 on the way to 15. Here it comes. Which Charles Dickens character is known for the phrase "Bah, humbug"? A. David Copperfield. B. Miss Havisham. C. Ebenezer Scrooge. D. Fagin. David Copperfield, Miss Havisham, Ebenezer Scrooge, Fagin. It was, of course, C, Ebenezer Scrooge. Green lights required. Everyone's got one. Kate in position 4 was the fastest again. Well done, Kate. From Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol. Question number 9. Used in cooking, vadouvan is a type of what? A, vinegar. B, goose fat. C, pastry. D, spice mix. Vadouvan. Need to be right, need to be the quickest. Vinegar, goose fat, pastry, spice mix. The answer is D, spice mix. Who got this one right? No one. Wow. There we go. And I hope you're doing better at home on this. We've had 3 clean sweeps. Question 10. Lonely Boy was a 2011 hit for which band? A, the Black Keys. B, the Black Crows. C, the Black Eyed Peas. D, Black Flag. 2011 hit for which band? Lonely Boy. Answer is the Black Keys. A. Green lights for those who got it right. 5 out of 6, but seat 5, Steve, was the fastest. Well done, Steve. All right, let's have a quick look at the leaderboard. It's getting close now. Kate is on 7. Trish is on 7, but have a look at the timing. 18.04 seconds to 18.20 seconds between Kate and Trish. Akiva is right up there as we speak as well. There's Kate and Trish going up there. Akiva on 6, Steve on 6, David on 6, and Rachel currently on 4. But have a look at that. 1 question between 1st and 5th. Let's go. 5 questions left. Everyone can still win. The water jet in Lake Burley Griffin is part of a memorial to which historical figure? A, Henry Lawson. B, Lachlan Macquarie. C, James Cook. D, Queen Victoria. Lake Burley Griffin in Canberra. The water jet pays tribute to James Cook. These people got it right. Two people, and David in seat six was the fastest. Well done, David. All right, that was the slowest finger first, that one almost. Everyone was taking their time. Question 12 on the road to question 15. Let's go. Which classic video game features characters nicknamed Inky, Pinky, Blinky, and Clyde? A, Donkey Kong, B, Space Invader, C, Pac-Man, D, Super Mario Brothers. Oh, some buyer's remorse over here. The answer is C, Pac-Man. Correct answers from just the one, Steve, in seat number five. Well done, Steve. Steve gets the money with the slowest, fastest finger ever, 7 seconds. He almost disqualified himself by going past 10 seconds, but was the only one to get it right, so you got the money. Well played. All right, this is a visual question, everybody. Have a good look at it. Now, the question is, this tentacled ocean creature is a sea what? A, anemone, B, slug, C, jelly, D, sponge. Tentacled ocean creature. Is A, an enemy, an enemy, an enemy, an enemy, and then an enemy. Who got this one right? Four people got it right, and Steve was the fastest again. He's coming home on the left side here. He went from 7 seconds to 0.7 of a second. Well played, Steve. All right, question 14, two to come. Which of these guitars is not made by Fender? A, Telecaster, B, Jazzmaster, C, Stratocaster, D, Flying V. Which of these guitars is not made by Fender? Answer is D, the Flying V. Correct answer is coming from four of our contestants. And in seat four, Kate was the fastest on the penultimate question. Well played. All right. Let's have a look at the leaderboard with one question to come and have a look at this. Wow. Steve is currently in the lead with 10. Kate is right there. And Kate, by the way, with 9, has got the fastest time there. So, Kate, you need to get a win. You want Steve to get it wrong, you need to get it right. David is hanging in there with 9. What you can do is just give him an elbow.
Yes, absolutely.
There, okay? David on 9. Trish is on 8. Akiva on 7. Rachel on 4. But Steve, Kate and David are all in a position to win the $1,000 and the chance to have the lifelines when we get to the hot seat. Final question. Good luck, everybody. Here it comes. In the 1870s, English philanthropist Sir Richard Wallace gave the city of Paris more than 50 what? A, drinking fountains, B, benches, C, street lamps, D, cannons. In the 1870s, Sir Richard Wallace of England gave the French, and more to the point, the Parisians, what? Drinking fountains. What's wrong?
I chose it.
You got it right, did you? All right. Who else got it right? Sounds like it was a guess. Kate was the fastest in her guess. By the way, there's the leaderboard, and with that last guess, did you see that? Now, Kate, let's be honest, that was a blind guess, wasn't it?
I had like a vague idea that's when they introduced water fountains.
Don't make it up now. You didn't have no idea, Kate.
Oh,
did you really?
Yeah.
Listen to a podcast. There you go. Wallace had been in Paris. He'd made Paris his second home. And he saw all the Parisians were really thirsty during the summer. So he decided to commission these new wonderful drinking fountains and had them made. And away then, and they're still there today. There's $1,000, Kate. Congratulations. Well played. Great stuff there, Kate. Of course, you can choose to keep that money or buy a lifeline as we go through the show. But you're going, well, have you been listening to any other podcasts lately?
Hopefully enough.
No, you're pretty happy with that, aren't you?
So happy. I just wanted to win $1,000
and I made it. Well, you won $1,000. Coming up after the break, Trish is going to try and do more than that. She wants to win $1 million in the hot seat right after this. Welcome back to the hot seat. Hey, before the seat, Kate, I want a high five from you. That's fantastic. How good was that? On the buzzer. Got the fastest finger.
Oh, my goodness, I'm still shaking.
You are. You're really pumped up about it, aren't you?
That's all I wanted to do.
Just win.
Yeah.
You've got $1,000.
Yeah, that's all I wanted.
Oh, you can come in and win a whole lot of money
I'm
now.
I'm like, yeah.
Are you going to take the 1,000 or do you reckon you might use it as a lifeline?
Everyone else has lost it, so I reckon I might keep it because $1,000.
You can win $100,000. You can win $1 million. Start getting greedy, Kate. That's the way. Hey, if you keep the 1,000, what are you going to do with that?
So I'm moving to South America.
Really?
Yeah, just last minute, whirlwind romance, decided two weeks ago.
Seriously? How long?
I need this.
So tell me about this bloke. How'd you meet him?
Met him at a music festival through my little sister.
Yeah?
And
whereabouts in South America is he from?
He's from Melbourne.
He's from Melbourne?
Yeah, we're just going to go.
That's the southern part of Australia, not America.
Yeah.
So he's Australian?
Yeah.
But you've decided to go to South America?
Yeah.
Whereabouts?
Everywhere. We're going to start in Buenos Aires because it's cheapest to fly to. This will get me there.
Yeah. And then what?
Conservation work somewhere.
Good on
diving.
You. Great stuff. Yeah. Wow, what a trip of a lifetime.
Right?
How long have you been together?
A month and a half.
Wow, really? Wow. Okay.
He was on this and he won $10,000.
He what?
He won $10,000 like a couple of years ago.
What, on hot seat?
Yeah.
Oh, he's a lucky... It's a hot seat romance. Yes.
Yeah.
There we go.
There
might be a lot more money for you to win, okay? In the meantime, Trish is going, all right, enough of that over there. Let's get in and play some big money. You ready to go, Trish?
Okay.
Let's play hot seat. Come on. Trish Hong is from Pomputa. Pomputa. Where's Pomputa in South Australia?
100 k's from Adelaide along the River Murray near Manham.
Oh, a good spot?
Houseboat capital.
Oh, it is. It's beautiful there,
lovely.
Isn't it? What's the highlight there, apart from the houseboats?
The weather.
The weather's great.
It's got a music festival once a year.
Yeah, there you go. Go to that one.
Good fishing.
Good fishing. What do you catch up there? Any Murray cod up there? Or?
Yeah, you can't catch them.
Yeah, I know you're not allowed to catch them, but...
I can't remember what he catches now, but there's lots of carp there.
There's lots
of people up there now who are actually doing lots of good things with carp.
Good stuff. Trish, you're retired, 66 years of age. What were you doing before retiring?
I was working in a bank.
What were you doing?
A home lender.
Home lender, good stuff. Which bank?
Westpac.
Westpac. Paula is your sister-in-law. Hi, Paula.
Hi, Eddie. How are you?
Welcome to the show. Do you get up on the houseboats as well?
Absolutely. It's fantastic.
You ready to go?
Certainly am.
Let's play Hot Seat now. Go. Which of these is the term for walking barefoot over hot stones or a bed of embers? A. Fire walking. B. Heat streaking. C. Hot shoe shuffling. D. Arson around.
I think that could be A. Fire walking.
Lock it in.
Yes,
you know all about that. Remember Nigel Smart at the Adelaide Crows? Did
yes,
it?
I do.
Got
I third
degree burns, didn't
That's
he?
That's right.
Fire walking is correct.
About that.
Yeah.
I remember it now.
I think more to the point, he might have been arsing around. Let's go for $200.
Okay.
Which of these is not the name of a film character portrayed by Arnold Schwarzenegger? A. John Kimball. B. Douglas Quaid. C. Harry Tasker. D. John Rambo. Not the name of a film character.
Well, I would lock in D. John Rambo.
Lock in John Rambo because that is... Sylvester Stallone. Correct for $200. $300 question, Trish. Good luck. Referring to an action made by horses, someone who is impatient is commonly said to be what at the bit? A. Bucking. B. Trotting. C. Chomping. D. Laughing. Sorry, champing, not chomping. Champing. D. Laughing. So bucking, trotting, champing, laughing.
I'll make that C, champing.
Champing.
Lock
champing
in.
At the bit. I actually fell in, you know, I was thinking, because people say chomping at the bit, and it's actually champing at the bit. And I talked myself into getting the wrong way around there, so I should just play it straight. You're correct, and it's $300. Well done. I got a bit excited. I was...
Champing at the bit.
I was. Let's take a break and come back and play for $1 million with Trish on the hot seat right after this. To the Millionaire Hot Seat. Trish Hong is playing beautifully. Let's go, Trish, for $500. What is Australia's second most populous state? A, Western Australia. B, New South Wales. C, Queensland. D, Victoria.
Very unsure of this one, so I'm going to take my pass at this stage.
Pass?
I'm going to pass. A. Yes, definitely.
Okay, see you, Trish. See you later. Hello, Akiva.
Howdy.
Welcome to the show. Akiva Kenner from St Kilda Eastern Victoria is a commerce student at Monash University, 22 years of age. Vic is your girlfriend. Hi, Vic.
Hey.
How are you?
Nervous.
That's it. That's good. Good to have some nervous energy here at the moment. How are you going, Akiva?
I'm all right.
Yeah, okay, sorry. Sorry for asking. You okay?
A little nervous.
Oh, a little nervous, that's the way. Hey, tell me about this. Where were you born?
I was born in Manchester in the UK.
In the UK. What brought you out to Australia?
Well, funny story. My dad got offered a job here, and I was petrified of needles at the time. And I knew that in year 10 in England, you got a tuberculosis injection that I didn't want. So I told him it would be a fabulous idea, move the whole family out to Australia. 8 years later, I told him why we actually moved. But turned out to be a good thing.
Good thing. Did you end up getting a TB injection?
No, apparently they stopped it in England as well, so I wouldn't have
Good stuff, mate. Akiva, what is Australia's second most populous state? Western Australia, New South Wales, Queensland or Victoria?
Pretty sure it would be D, Victoria.
Lock it in?
Lock it in.
In. Correct, for $500. New South Wales has 7.6 million. Victoria's got about 6 million. Queensland, 4.8. WA, about 2.6. $1,000. The German word Tannenbaum is commonly associated with which of these festive occasions? A. Easter. B. Christmas. C. Valentine's Day. D. Halloween.
I've got absolutely no idea. I'm going to pass.
See you later. Thanks, Akiva.
See you.
Hello, Rachel.
Hello, Eddie. How are you?
I'm well. Rachel Mountford is from Richmond in New South Wales.
I am.
Tell me about your business.
So I import beauty products and equipment from Poland.
What sort of equipment do you get from Poland?
Slimming and facelifting.
Really?
Yeah, I try and convince people that
I'm
80. Yeah, I do actually, but in the.
What are you saying? I need it?
No, not at all.
You sure?
No, I just to if anyone in the audience. Needs
thank you very much, yeah. Rachel. Good recovery. Let's go. The German word Tannenbaum is commonly associated with which of these festive occasions? Easter, Christmas, Valentine's Day, Halloween.
I have absolutely no idea. Halloween, I don't believe would be Christmas.
Seven.
Doesn't sound like Easter. I'm just going to have to take a punt and go Easter.
Easter? Locked in? No, it's Christmas.
Crap.
Yeah, literally translated, the word means fir tree.
Oh, well, there you go.
The Christmas carol, O Christmas Tree, is an English version of the German song, O Tannenbaum.
Not to worry.
Sorry, Rach.
Thank you so
All
much.
All the best.
See
you later.
Thank you.
Hello, Kate. Hi. Hello, Kate Ward from Northcote in Victoria, who is 27 years of age, international studies and language student, and a telephone interviewer. What does that mean?
I call people for the government and ask them how they feel.
Oh, from the government?
Yeah, usually from the government.
You get a few nice answers, I'm sure.
Yeah, absolutely.
What sort of questions do you ask them?
About, like, health or, like, public views.
All that sort of thing?
Yeah.
And we've heard from you because you are our winner tonight of Fastest Finger First. You've got a cheque for $1,000 in your hand. And you're about to head overseas, but don't forget that you now have three lifelines to choose from. Make it four because you've got the pass, but you can buy the other three. If you decide to go for one of them, I'm going to stop the clock, and then you can either choose to ask a friend. And in the audience, you've got Caitlin, who's your best friend. Hi, Caitlin.
Hi, Eddie.
Good to see you. There's 50-50, which gets rid of two incorrect answers, and the switch, which means we get rid of this question that you don't like altogether and give you a brand new question, OK? We want you to win $250,000.
Me too.
So you can go overseas. When are you planning to go overseas with your new boyfriend?
Yeah, well, we're going to buy... If I win over $150,000, we're going to buy a boat and take my dog, because my dog has to stay behind this time.
What sort of boat is going to get you to South America?
Well, a sailing boat.
You haven't really thought this through at all,
Kate. I'll buy a boat there. I'll ship the dog over. It'll be fine.
All right, OK, Kate. Let's take a break, see if we can buy a boat to go to South America right after this with Kate. Back to the hot seat, and our fastest finger winner, Kate, is ready to play. Kate Ward. Let's go for $1,000, Kate.
Okay.
Good luck.
Thanks.
Which of these is a mountain overlooking Rio de Janeiro in Brazil? You're heading to South America. A. Sugarloaf. B. Honey Bread. C. Sweet Bun. D. Lamington.
Oh, no. Oh. from Brazil. I'm going to throw my pass out there.
You can pass and
yeah,
go
I'm gonna
if you
pass.
Like.
Yeah, I'm
going to
pass.
See you, Kate. Catch you later. Bye. That was a very quick departure from Kate. Steve Graham is in the hot seat. Hello. Who was leading fastest finger until the very last question from Sunbury, a library assistant at the RMIT University Library, 33 years of age. Nikki's your wife. Hi, Nikki.
Hi, Eddie.
Welcome to the show. Good luck tonight. Let's get this one out of the way. Come on, Steve. What, you laughing?
I have no idea.
You have no idea?
No idea.
Come on, have a look at it, mate. Which of these, knock a few out, which of these is a mountain overlooking Rio de Janeiro in Brazil? Okay. Sugarloaf.
Well, I don't think it's Lamington.
Hang on, I'm not going to give you the answer.
Oh, okay.
Sugarloaf, honey bread, sweet bun, Lamington. They wouldn't shut up about this during the Olympic Games. Rio de Janeiro in Brazil.
Okay, well, I don't think it's Lamington. I'm thinking... I really have no idea.
5 seconds.
Sugarloaf.
Lock in Sugarloaf Mountain. Of course it is, for $1,000. Hey! Well done. Well played. All right, 1500. What does the G stand for in the magazine name GQ? A, golf. B, gentlemen's. C, gourmet. D, geographic.
I'm sort of thinking gentlemen's, but you know, I don't really know. I don't read it. I'm not interested in golf. GQ, yeah. It's kind of one of those general magazines about lots of stuff, isn't it?
I'm going to
lock in B, gentlemen's.
Lock in B, gentlemen's. Correct for $1,500. $2,500. Opium is a classic line of women's fragrances created in the 1970s by which design house? A. Giorgio Armani. B. Yves Saint Laurent. B. Givenchy. D. Chanel.
Well, I'm, you know, up on my women's fragrances. I'm not sure. Again, I don't really have a clue.
Opium.
It could
women's
be,
fragrance,
it could be any
1970s.
70s. I'm thinking maybe Chanel, but that's just a guess.
10, you can pass.
Yeah, let's go Chanel.
Is that what you want to do?
Yeah, why not?
Let's do it. All right, I'll tell you why not, because it's wrong.
Oh.
it was Yves Saint Laurent. Yeah. One of the top-selling women's fragrances since it was launched by the French fashion house back in 1977. Nikki's looking down askance at you saying, why don't you buy me some and then you would know. Thanks, Steve.
Because she asked for Armani.
Good on you, mate. Cheers, buddy. See ya. Hello, David Rao.
Hello, Eddie McGuire.
Welcome to the show. Retired at 57 years of age. What did you do, rob a bank?
No, I worked in life insurance for a number of years and had a bit of an illness which sort of laid me low for a while and then just basically had a little bit of legal trouble with them and I basically got out of the
industry.
Decided to get out of it.
So you're going to have a break for a while?
Break, rethinking what I'm going to do.
Good on you. That's a good way to do it, just recalibrate at 57 years of age. Plenty of time ahead of you.
Absolutely.
From East Keeler in Victoria, wife Kari, had been married for 22 years, Spencer's 13, Griffin is 11. Let's get this $2,500 question out of the way.
Great.
Good luck, David.
Thank you.
Who stars in the 2016 New Zealand film Hunt for the Wilder People? Hunt for the Wilder People. A. Rebecca Gibney. B. Sam Neill. C. Liam Hemsworth. D. Margot Robbie. Hunt for the Wilder People. Great movie. 2016 New Zealand film.
Haven't seen it. I'm a big film buff, and it would just be a guess, so I think I'm going to pass.
You're going to pass?
Yes.
Okay. See you, David. Catch you later. Come on, Trish, you've got a bit of work to do here.
Sure have.
Seven questions for $100,000. Trish Hong, who stars in the 2016 New Zealand film Hunt for the Wilder People? Great movie. Rebecca Gibney, Sam Neill, Liam Hemsworth, Margot Robbie.
I think that's B, Sam Neill.
Lock it in?
Yep, lock it in.
In. Correct for $2,500. $1,000 The fabulous Sam Neill.
He's wonderful.
He's a wonderful actor and a sensational bloke. Okay, $4,000. Which of these does not feature in the lyrics of Men at Work's 1980s hit Down Under? A. Combi. B. Beer. C. Holden. D. Vegemite.
Yeah, they have a combi. And Vegemite, definitely. And I think they have beer. I don't think... I think it's C. I'll go for C. I'll lock in C.
Lock in C. They have a fried out combi, don't they?
They do.
She just smiled and gave me a Vegemite sandwich?
Yep.
No Holden. Holden's correct for $4,000. Well played. Five questions to go for $100,000. Four contestants. Everyone's in the money when we return in the hot seat next. Welcome back. Trish Hong playing beautifully at the moment for $6,000. Come on, Trish. Five more answers will get you 100 grand.
Oh.
Tasty Z and Double Jewel are both varieties of which fruit? A. Peach. B. Cherry. C. Banana. D. Pineapple. Tasty Z and Double Jewel.
I can't think of any. Double Jewel.
15.
Cherry, peach.
Can you put a line through any of them? 10.
I think I might just go for D, pineapple.
Final answer?
It's my final answer, Doug.
It's in, and it's wrong. I'm sorry, Trish, it's a peach.
Oh,
yeah, Tasty Z is a white-fleshed peach and Double Jewel is the yellow-fleshed variety. You were sensational. Good luck with everything on the houseboats on the Murray.
Thanks
very much,
Eddie.
Trish. You're
nice
wonderful.
To you.
Good to see
Thank
you.
You.
Hello, Akiva.
Hello.
Come on, mate. You are within striking distance of $50,000 here. You ready for your question? A commerce student from Monash University. Let's go for $6,000. In the British Armed Forces, which of these is a term for an officer's personal valet? A. Aquaman. B. Batman. C. Birdman. D. Darkman.
Got no idea.
British Armed Forces, the probably, officer's personal valet.
Probably not Aquaman or Birdman. I'm thinking Batman. I'm not sure. I think... Can I still pass?
No. Nope. 10 seconds.
Tossing up B or D. Lock in D.
Final answer?
B. Batman. Final answer.
You said Batman, then went to Darkman. Then back to Batman in the last second. Why?
I've rung some bell somewhere.
Batman is correct for $6,000. $10,000. Which of these iconic Australian brands is the oldest? A. Vegemite. B. Tim Tam. C. 4 and 20. D. Ugg.
Don't think it's Ugg. Or Vegemite. I reckon B or C. Pies are pretty Australian. I'll lock in C. 4 and 20.
4 and 20 pies locked in. It's actually the oldest is Vegemite. Yeah. First created in 1922 by chemist Cyril Callister. And good news is Vegemite has become Australian again, brought back from Kraft. He was commissioned to create a rival spread to England's Marmite. 4 and 20 was in the 40s, Tim Tams in the 60s, and Ugg Boots in the 70s. Akiva, that's where it ends for you, pal. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Good to see you. Now, Kate, you've got $1,000 in your hand. Hold it up, show me that. There it is, there's $1,000. If you get this one right, I'll give you another $1,000. And if you get the next one right, I'll give you another $20,000. How about that?
That'd be so good.
Yeah, and you'd spend it straight away, wouldn't you?
Absolutely.
Yeah, what on? The airline tickets?
I
buy everyone dinner.
Yeah.
Just lots of good stuff. Buy a backpack.
Yeah.
A backpack. I'd get my dog DNA tested because he's a mongrel and I'd like to know.
Yeah.
The rest's on travelling.
Good stuff.
Yeah. What's buy it my cost? Mum and dad something nice.
Yeah, that's something for mum and dad. They've looked after.
Yeah, they're
your brothers
good.
And sisters?
Two little sisters. Yeah, I'd buy them something. Yeah, for sure.
Okay.
Take them on holiday.
Well, take them on holiday?
Yeah.
It's to, we're playing for 20,000, not 20 million here, by the way, Kate.
I'm thrifty.
That's it. Good stuff. You're 27.
Yeah.
You're an international studies and language student. What do you speak?
Spanish, fairly well. French, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And heading off to South America with a new boy. What's his name?
Jono.
Yeah. And Jono won money here?
Yeah.
How much?
$10,000.
So you've got a chance to go past him here. You win $20,000. All right, fingers crossed. Good luck.
My goodness.
You ready, Kate?
No.
This is for another $1,000.
Okay.
Which of these James Cameron films was released first? A. Aliens. B. The Abyss. C. The Terminator. D. True Lies.
All right, I'm going to take my lifeline, which I wasn't going to do.
Oh, you're going to spend $1,000
yep.
to win $1,000
yep.
and then go for $20,000.
Yep.
You want to use your lifeline?
Yeah, because Kate's good at movies.
All right, stop the clock. All right. Don't look at it! Hey, turn around here. You're not allowed to look at it. What are you doing?
Really?
Stop
cheating.
I'm going to have to.
Yeah,
I'm sorry, I'm going to have to disqualify you, okay?
Oh, really?
No.
Oh, thank God. Emotional day. Oh,
anyway, you've got to stick with Kate now because you've looked around so you can't do anything else there. Sugar.
Yeah. Timbers.
Hey, do
no,
tear it up.
Don't.
Tear it up.
This is so
all I wanted was to win $1,000.
I know,
and then
I
the little bug on your shoulder just bit your ear, the gambling bug.
I haven't even heard.
Alright, Kate is going for Ask a Friend.
Oh, God.
And that friend is her best friend, Caitlin Stevens. Hello, Caitlin.
Hi, Eddie.
Alright. Okay, you ready, Caitlin? I'll ask you the question. Here it comes.
Oh, my goodness.
Which of these James Cameron films was released first? Aliens, The Abyss, The Terminator, or True Lies?
I think I can probably narrow it down. I think it's between A and C, but I could be wrong and I don't want to.
Well, that's right, you're going 50-50. Come on.
Yeah.
You don't have to give an answer, but you've got 16 seconds. You've got to give me the answer. What's it to be? What are you saying? 10.
Terminator.
What are you going to go with, Kate? 5 seconds. Lock one in, quick.
Aliens.
What?
Aliens.
She said Terminator.
I know.
Why did you turn to her?
Because I'm scared.
But why didn't you say Terminator?
Because I'm scared.
She said Terminator.
Tell me she was wrong.
You tore up $1,000 to ask her.
I know.
And then she told you the answer.
Don't
she said aliens or Terminator. She went for Terminator and you burned her and said, no, I don't believe in you, Caitlin, you're a goose. And she's right. Hey, Caitlin, how happy are you, though, just at the moment?
I'm just glad it wasn't my fault. That
no, that's what I mean. It wasn't
your
fault. She asks you the questions. She do that all the time, ask you for advice and then just burn you.
Yeah, I mean, she's clearly a little bit off, isn't she?
She's wonderful, Kate. She's going to have a great time. Sorry, Kate. We wish you could win $1,000. We wish you could win $20,000, but you're not going to have anything. Sorry. David.
Yes.
You've won $1,000.
Thank you.
You've actually taken Kate's $1,000. How do you feel about that?
Not terrific.
Hey, David, we'll take a news break. We're going to come back and play for $10,000. David's in the hot seat. Come on, David, let's go. Good luck, buddy. This is for $10,000.
Thank you.
What is the name of Al Pacino's character in the 1972 film The Godfather?
A, Vito. B, Sonny. C, Michael. D, Federico.
Sonny was his brother. Vito was the father. Federico, Freddy was might have been the other brother. But anyway, I'm certain that it is Michael, so lock in C.
Lock in C, Michael Corleone. You've made me an offer that I can't refuse. You've won $10,000. That's David Rowe. He's won $10,000. I'll see you next time in the Millionaire Hot Seat. Good night, everyone. Hot seat tonight, you name it, it's hot. And we've got a brand new show, hour-long show, bringing back some of the great millionaire favourites, Fastest Finger First and The Lifelines, giving everybody the biggest and best chance of winning $1 million. How about that, everybody? Cannot wait. Our six contestants will play two rounds of Fastest Finger First. Each contestant has a touch screen. I'll show them the question. Four alternative answers are there. They'll have 10 seconds to look for the answer and lock it in. At the end of 15 questions, the contestant who's locked in the most correct answers but in the fastest time wins $1,000 cash. Well done. That's it. And that's where it just starts, because that $1,000 then can be traded in and buy a lifeline later on in the show. Those lifelines are 50-50, ask a friend, or the switch, which gets rid of the question altogether, in the main game when we're playing for the big money of $1 million tonight. Let's meet our contestants playing for that $1 million tonight. And in seat number one, we have Trish Hong, who ate pizza with British actor Warren Mitchell from Till Death Us Do Part. After a big night, Akiva Kennard couldn't get in the door, so he tried to crawl through the cat flap. Rachel Mountford met her now husband in kindergarten, but only reconnected last year on Facebook. Kate Ward always has a few hobbies on the go, but never finishes any of them, Kate. Steve Graham snorkeled in a city fountain that he'd filled with dishwashing liquid. And David Rowe looked like he'd been shot after eating an ice cream sundae with raspberry sauce. There you go. All right, guys. Round one is ready to go. It's time to play Fastest Finger First. Good luck, everybody. Heads down. Let's go for it. Question one. According to a common Australian expression, a strong, healthy person is said to be as fit as a what bull? A, Murray. B, Murrumbidgee. C, Mallee. D, Chicago. Murray Bull, Murrumbidgee Bull, Mallee Bull, Chicago Bull. People are frustrated already. We're only at question one. Settle down, guys. The answer is a Mallee Bull. The green light tells us who got it right. Five people got it. And position number three, Rachel, was the fastest. Well played. Question two. Founded in Ohio in 1969, which of these is one of the world's largest hamburger chains? A, Steve's. B, Wendy's. C, Michael's. D, Linda's. 1969 in Ohio. One of the world's largest hamburger chains is B, Wendy's. Again, we're looking for a green light for those who got it right. Green lights everywhere bar next door to me. And position four, Kate is the fastest this time. Well done, Kate. Good job. Question three. An HC license required to drive an articulated truck with three or more axles stands for heavy what? A, carriage. B, cartage. C, connection. D, combination. Carriage, cartage, connection, combination, heavy what? HC license. Answer is combination. Did anyone get this one right? No, 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 no. No one got it right. Everybody got it wrong. Okay, question four. This is a visual question, so have a look at the screens. Have a good look there. Now the question. Located in Canberra, what is